What's up, guys? Welcome back to a brand new video. Sorry for not uploading for like 5 months. Yeah, but anyways, in this video, I'm gonna show you guys how to create a Perlin noise and how to create how to generate maps basically with Perlin noise. So let's start off by creating our block. We're gonna set the size to 4 on all axes or whatever, and I'm gonna rename this to block. We put that in server script service. After that, we're gonna add a new script in server script service, and we're gonna start scripting. So what we do first is we're gonna make a seed. Local seed is equal to math.random 1 to 1,000. Now choose a random number between 1 and 1,000. And next, what we're gonna do is we're gonna assign the map size. So local map size, set it to 50. Now it's important that you make it so when this map size is divided by 2, there won't be any decimals in it, basically just like a plain number. So I'm just gonna do a local map scale is equal to 50 divided by 2. All right, so what we're gonna do now is we're gonna do 4 x axes is equal to map scale minus map scale minus map scale, and then like this, add a comma or something like that, and do map scale. Boom. Now I just gotta copy this like that, and do z axis. So it's a z axis and x axis here. Next, what we're gonna do is we're gonna do local noise is equal to math dot noise, and then we basically gotta make it choose a number by simply assigning the seed and the x axis and divide that by 12. I'm going to do c axis and divide that by 12 and then multiply by 8. Okay, after that, what we're going to do is we're going to clone the block from the server script service. So we're going to script the parent dot block colon clone. We need to make this a variable, so local block is equal to script dot parent block clone. So we need to do block dot position is equal to vector 3 dot new, and we got to make it so that's the x axis. And we need to multiply this by 4 because our block size is 4. So we're going to do like that. And do math.floor. Math.floor. And make that noise. And then we need to multiply it by 4. And then c axis times 4. The block. Block dot parent is equal to workspace. So we did this pretty quickly, and we're gonna see if it works now. So okay, so as you see right here, it works. Oops, and I forgot to anchor the block, so it kind of looked like it fell down there. But let's start. As you can see here that we have a randomly generated map, which is pretty cool, and let's try to look from 0, 0 here. Okay, there. I'm just placing it here so that we can get a good look at how the map will generate. So let's start. You see right here, it generates pretty well. So let's see here again. Yeah, so that's it's pretty cool. You can also do the maps bigger if you want. I'm gonna try and do it here, 200. Now this is an unoptimized version, so it's gonna lag a bit. But as you see right here, it doesn't really look like it increased much, but Oh yeah, I forgot here. It needs to be map size divided by 2 here. Okay. So, yep, it's a little bit laggy here, but now you can see it generates pretty large randomly generated maps here. Which is pretty cool. And yeah, I will show you guys in the next video how to generate trees and stuff. So stay tuned for that. See you.